guys, Lugadan Gaming here, and welcome to another tutorial video on this channel. And today, this could be how to install the shaders mods for Minecraft 1.8. Sorry, I'm not sure if it's for 1.8.1. Feel free to try at the end of this video, or you can just continue doing the 1.8. Also, this does not affect any of your saves, so even if you don't believe us, feel free to back up any of your saves on Minecraft just in case anything bad happens. Now, I will include both of these links in the description below. So, firstly, we have the Sonic Ethers Unbelievable Shaders, which is just an amazing shader. I tried it. And also, before I start, I would like to say that I recommend that you have a really good PC before attempting to even run shaders, because I struggle to run it on this really good PC. So, firstly, we're going to install the Sonic Ether Unbelievable. Just scroll down past all of these screenshots until you come to the SUS version 10.1. And I like to install the Ultra, so just click that. Now, when you come to this AdFly page, I'd recommend not clicking any of this stuff, as it could get you viruses. Even if it looks secure, do not click it, because then you have read and accept it. Download. Okay, so now if we just drag this to my desktop, now we do not need that page anymore. Now, for the shaders mod, you will need to go to here for Minecraft 1.8, or if you're running on 1.7.10, go below and do the download stuff like here. But for this video, we're gonna be going on here, so we'll click on alpha version 2.4.4. It'll take you to his latest post and just click download page 1. Same as before, do not click any of the stuff around you, just wait until you can skip the ad. Excuse me. Right, skip the ad. And yeah, my computer could run a bit slow because I am uploading my Titanfall. But right. So click download. Right, now you want to click keep. Now, yes, I've been having a bit of a problem with this, I'll sort it out in a second. But actually, no, we'll just get rid of that. Well, that'll be it anyways, this is what it'll appear as. So, next, you're going to want to go to your start menu and type in percent app data percent. Then you're going to want to go to your .minecraft. Then here, you're going to want to make a folder called shader packs. If I can actually spell it right. Call it shader packs, and then what you're going to want to do is drag your SUS into that shader pack folder. Now, what's going to happen is if I click this, hopefully it doesn't work. Okay, so it'll say it can't find version 1.8. Now, that's because I've wiped my Minecraft just to show you fully, just install Battlefield. So, just search Minecraft. So basically, I'm just showing you the full step. Okay, now we just need to. Alright. God, I haven't changed that password in a while. So, we're going to want to edit profile and click 1.8. Now, just leave everything as it is, save your profile, and click play. Now, the FPS could mess up as I am recording my desktop and I'm playing Minecraft in windowed mode, so. You know, hopefully it's not too bad. So just move that into the middle. So we will just let Minecraft load. There we go. So there you go. We got Minecraft. We will now close that down. Then get off my screen. Double click shaders mod. It should work this time after you've created it. Click yes. Okay. And there it is, installed it, shader mod 2.4.4, click OK, and you now no longer require that shaders mod. Next, you're going to want to, sorry I haven't got it on my desktop, I'm keeping it quite tidy for once. Just launch Minecraft again, there we go. Then what you're going to want to do is edit profile. Now, as you can see, it has created its own profile, so if you go here, you've got version 8, keep it as 8.1, otherwise it will not work. Now I'm just going to name this, my name again. Then for this is just to help for allocating more RAM, so that 1 gig stands for 1 gigabyte. So say for me, since I have 8 gig of RAM, I'll usually select half of what I have. So if you have 4 gig, select 2 gig. If you have 16, select, well, just don't go above 4, there's really no point. But if you have 1 gig, like 2 gig of RAM, then you're stuck with 1. So sorry about that. Make sure that's all right. Save profile and then click play. Now I am gonna try and play this in windowed mode. Just, I don't know why. I do apologize if this seems pretty rushed. I only learned it not long ago. But if you go into options, shaders, SUSE 10.1, click done. Okay. And then we click select world. Actually, I'm just gonna create. Okay, now we'll just name it new world, creative. Here we go, loading world, building terrain. And then when it comes on, you will see that we are running on the brand new shaders. So all my settings will be refreshed. So wait a minute. So as you can see, you now have shaders working. It is a pretty hard piece of, you know, mod to run on Minecraft, but when you're not, well, even if you do have a good computer, even when you're not recording, it is still gonna be perfectly playable. I run at about 30 FPS. But yeah, here you go, that this is Minecraft. And keep this in mind that this mod is in alpha, so there will be lots of bugs with blocks and stuff. But here you go, you do have Minecraft on here. So let me just turn down the settings so I can show you better. So if we go to video, particles, minimal. I have no clue what that does. There we go, that should run a bit better. But there you go guys, if this did help you out, don't forget to drop the video a like. And yeah, comment down what you do think of this mod. I do think it is pretty cool for Minecraft. So I've been Little Eggdan Gaming, don't forget to subscribe if you saw new to become Cobra Day, join the Cobra Nation. And yeah, this mod pack is absolutely amazing. If this did help you out, like I said, drop it a like. I'll see you in my latest videos. And yeah, how does this look? Oh god, the sun. Wait, let's go like this. I'll see you guys later, and peace.